men's singles match between Singapore's Loh Kean Yew and Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, the third seed from Indonesia. We've just seen, of course, in the men's draw that Anders Antonsen has defeated Leland Shu, a match he was really probably the overwhelming favourite to win. He awaits now Kieran George Okunlu at Vittetsan. Brian Yang is through because Li Zijia was down a game and then had to retire. And so that makes it intriguing for the winner of this. That is a big, big incentive in many ways. With all respect to Brian Yang, I'd rather than probably rather face him than Li Zijia. It's going to be deafening in here. I hope you can hear everything that we're saying. These two are immensely popular. Obviously, Ginting playing at home, but Loh Kean Yew is huge here. They know their badminton. They love their stars. But Loh Kean Yew, just with his friendly disposition, his boyish charm, he's really got Indonesian fans in the palm of his hand at times. And I bet some spit loyalties here, maybe. Now, split loyalties or not, serious matter at hand here of this quarterfinal, and Loh Kean Yew will not enjoy what's about to happen on screen here. He is trailing Ginting 5-2, their last meeting in the China Masters, just a short few months ago, where he won in straight games, and he's won the last five in a row as well.
You want my right side?
Not had a good record against the Indonesian in recent times.
You receive Ginting, you serve.
He'll be absolutely desperate to change that here. World number 4 gets to world number 12. More on that in just a short while. Well, this is certainly a blockbuster clash. So Loh Kean Yew is 26 years of age, 175 centimetres tall, from Penang in Malaysia, born there but moved to Singapore as a young boy. He's now 12th in the world, though it wasn't all that long ago that he was the world number 3. That was achieved just over a year ago. He's of course a former world champion in 2021. Stunning result that one was. He's beaten Pranoy and Suli Young. Had to battle against Pranoy. Asian Championship last year. He played this very man here in the final and came in second. Loh Kean Yew won multiple medals at the Southeast Asian Games level. And we'll talk about his titles in just a short while, but here's Ginting, 27, 171 centimetres tall. Fourth in the world. He's been higher at number 2. That was in January, almost exactly a year ago. He has been an Olympic bronze medalist at the last Olympics. Former Asian Games bronze medalist, that's his record. No games dropped thus far. Asian Championships, of course, he's the reigning champion. As I said, he beat Loh Kean Yew. He's a former Youth Olympic bronze medalist as well from 2014. Win Kong Huang from Vietnam is our umpire. Chen Yuqi from China is our service judge. 6 titles in the World Tour for Ginting, including last year's Singapore Open, where he lost to Antonsen in the final. He also was runner-up at the Indonesia Open, where he lost to Victor Axelsen. He's won the Milo Open. He's also a former winner of the Indonesia Masters in 2020 and 2018. So this tournament,
ready, play.
He has won twice before. Loh Kean Yew, in terms of titles on the World Tour. He has won twice, the Thailand Masters in 2019 and the Hilo Open in 2021. He's finished runners-up last year at the Korea Open, where he lost to Antonsen. So the feeling is he hasn't really been able to push on since that World Championship win where he made such a name for himself, put the tiny country of Singapore on the map. He's the first Singaporean to win that title. He's done it ahead of some heavyweights like Malaysia, which will rankle given that he was born in that country. These two playing up to the crowd a little, enjoying themselves, why not? Loh Kean Yew got to the semi-finals here in 2022. That's his best performance. He's hoping to match that here now. A few smiles on the face of these players. We're in for a treat.
Ladies,
two great players in terms of court coverage and recovery.
Sinisuka, Ginting,
shot selection.
Indonesia. And on my left, Loh Kean Yew, Singapore.
There you go, pretty good reception for someone not from Indonesia. What will be of concern to Loh Kean Yew is that the last five, as I said, have all gone Ginting's way. He has not dropped a game. It has been very straightforward for Ginting against Loh. And he's their last remaining hope here. And the men's singles as well. Just long for Loh. Great start here from Ginting. First point on the board for the Singaporean.
Serving over. 1-3.
Drives here and then he was quick on again. As I said, these two very, very fast around the court. A great shot from Loh. A little help there for Ginting off the net. Yeah, nothing you can do really when that happens. Some of the crowd thought that was in.
3-5.
It's interesting, isn't it, because we've played, what, 4 minutes, 9 points on the board, and we've barely had any big rallies. And you compare that to how it was at times between Anders Antonsen and Leland Schier, quite a few rallies in that one. Not enough height in that. And he's putting that away as he should, Ginting. Well, that's well wide again. Down that forehand side for Ginting.
4-7.
Said he did not want to be careless and let his enthusiasm down when facing Ginting in the quarterfinals. I'd say that is fairly careless. Said always difficult to face Ginting, and we're playing at the Astora, so he was trying to put the pressure on Ginting, says, but as the home player, the pressure's on him, because everyone's going to be focused on him. But of course, I will try my best, and hopefully I can win. He said he's happy to be able to compete again here at the Senayan, Astora Senayan, considering that he's got a lot of fans. He's got his nickname, Astora Boy, or Astora Guy. He's always very warm and friendly to his supporters, and that, and the players as well, they love him. Popular. He didn't deny that the fans played a role in his victory over Suli Young yesterday. Said he was very happy to be back and really enjoyed that match. He said he really enjoyed that match yesterday. Loh Kean Yew. He said he's happy to be back, and the emotions from the audience helped. And he said, I hope they give me support against Ginting, which is cheeky. That's a wide. He said, let's see tomorrow whether they're with me or against me. Oh, right now, they're with Ginting, that's for sure. Four points, decent lead here for Ginting. More like it, that's the power that he can generate. Loh Kean Yew. Just very little back lift. Bam. It was interesting yesterday that Ginting said he... had to change his tactics. He had a patient playing style yesterday. against Leong Jun Hao of Malaysia. He won that in straights.
Anthony Ginting,
we have a challenge here from Ginting. Hao. Out.
Challenge,
and he had to play a little, as I said, a little bit more conservatively.
Nine, ten.
Said he, the last two matches, he's had to play like that. But he noticed there was a slight change in his opponent's strategy in the second game, so he played more patiently then and employed the strategy that his coach told him to, and he said it worked well. So I think it can't be patient here necessarily against someone like Loh Kean Yew. Different sort of match this one. Oh, that's one I think he knows he has to be better on Loh Kean Yew. It's a 2-point lead here for Anthony Ginting in game one, 11-9. So just a 2 points then for Ginting, who led by four at one stage. This big clash against Loh Kean Yew, who's just 1 point away. 10-11. Oh, that is excellent. From Ginting. Just about the power. So beyond the reach. You have to get that really accurate against someone like Loh Kean Yew.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was interesting in the Indonesian press where it's been touted that he's got a bit of a secret. Ginting. Against Loh Kean Yew, he said he's got a number of plans. He said his strategy is a secret. Well, it's only a point in it. So maybe he's just waiting to deploy that plan at some point. Near the umpires on the other side this time, near the service judge. But that was tight. My initial reaction was that it was in for Ginting. It was given out. And if he's unsuccessful, then Loh Kean Yew will draw level. That
no
is probably the tightest one we've seen this afternoon.
12-all.
So far in the last few matches.
Three.
Nothing between them. That one is good, it slides. It was in and slid across the surface there, across the line. See, Loh Kean Yew was prepared for some kind of powerful kill. Just nudges it over. So a brief lead there for Loh Kean Yew. By the way, that when Loh went up 13-12 was the first time in this game, the only time in this game that he had the lead. Loh now increases that lead. Now, good time to do so. Again, we don't want to get ahead of ourselves. There's still plenty more in this first game, but he has not won a first game in a long, long, five long matches. So sure, he's not going to be resting on any laurels just yet. There's a long way to go. Like a stop drop. Percentages here.
Loh Kean Yew, low. Lay.
Low hit the headlines not too long ago in Singapore. Just over 3 weeks ago for announcing his impending marriage. Christmas Eve, he proposed to his fiance.
Hey.
have registered his marriage. They tied the knot in the first quarter of last year. They're all very quiet. Been very tight-lipped about his relationship. Any details of his wife either. He just wants the privacy, which is fair enough, but he's now trailing by two here. Make that three. Been a number of unforced errors from Loh Kean Yew in the last few minutes.
18-50.
Yeah, needs to finish that off, and he does.
Service over. 16-18.
Well, the feeling is maybe some wedded bliss might just give him that dream of winning Singapore's first badminton medal at the Olympics. Remember, the man he's playing against did that. Got a bronze at the Tokyo Games. And he was 42 in the world before when he was knocked out of the Olympics in July 2021, and then 5 months later he was the world champion. Then got to number three. Quite the rally here. Got longer. Oh, wonderful skills from Loh Kean Yew to recover. But that's a brilliant smash. By far our best rally of this match thus far. One which is won by Ginting. But both these players showing supreme athleticism. Look at this. And is sliding back to make the return. But then, look at this. First class smash from Ginting. Nothing he can do about that. He can't recover, he can't dive again. He's picked his spot perfectly, Ginting.
Thank you. Ginting.
So he's two away, Ginting, from this first game. Skim the net there from Ginting. Looks probably helped him a little bit, and he's now got 4 game points.
20 game points, 50.
See if he can convert the first time of asking. One saved.
Serving over. 17-20.
Still 3 more here for Loh Kean Yew. Both playing stop drops. Again, that clips the net. Doesn't make it over. Ginting once again for the sixth match in a row. Wins his opening game against Loh Kean Yew. To the delight of this sellout crowd here, the Istora Senayan. Action packed. Some great shots played by both players, maybe just towards the end. Loh Kean Yew might look back at some of the unforced errors that he made. Ginting, though, edges proceedings. There you go, look at that. 21-17 to Ginting.
Second game, double play.
Well, that was quite the first game, of course, helped by the crowd atmosphere here. Ginting has won it, as has been the case in the previous five matches between the two. Takes the opening point here as well. You have to go back to 2022, August, when Loh Kean Yew last beat Ginting. That was in a Thomas and Newman Cup match in Bangkok. Won in straight game. That's a great result, that one. Prior to that, he beat Ginting in 2014, Indonesia Masters. Not this one. Well, that was a long, long time ago, so we can pretty much discount that. Four times in 2022, they met twice in 2023. China Masters, I mentioned, and also the Asia Championships in the final, where Ginting thrashed Loh Kean Yew. Just to give you an idea of things, by the way, of the five previous matches that Ginting has beaten Loh Kean Yew, this score today, the 21-17, the 17 points that Loh Kean Yew scored, is the joint highest he scored against Ginting in those last five matches, now six. And that was at the Singapore Open, the semi-finals of 2022. Since then, he's scored 13, 12, 12, 15. So if you're looking for crumbs of comfort, if you're a Loh Kean Yew fan, is that he's at least scored more points against Ginting today than at any other time except Singapore Open semi-final of the last six matches played. He's trailing again here, as he did early on in that first game.
Yeah.
Loh's year so far. Well, he was out in the first round of the Malaysia Open. He had to play Victor Axelsen. That's the problem when you're out of those top eight rankings or so. You don't get the seed. He lost pretty comfortable style to his good friend. Wasn't able to play in the India Open. Ginting hasn't had a particularly great start to the year either. Out in the second round of the Malaysia Open to Luke Wang Tu. The Lee Chuk Yew beat him in the quarterfinals of the India Open. In three. Plays a big part in that one for Ginting. Yes, well, I wasn't wrong there. Played a big part, didn't let him get him over. Well, for Ginting in the 2023. Nine semi-finals for Ginting last year. Four wins, five defeats. Second half of the year, as we know, not so great for him. After the French Open quarterfinal, he never really performed up to scratch. So four wins, five losses in quarterfinals last year. Mixed bag for Loh Kean Yew. Two wins in quarterfinals. Excuse me.
Seven, four.
Again there from the Singaporean. Record. Loh Kean Yew in semi-finals has been in 24 of them up till now. He's won 12 and lost 12. As for Ginting, he's won 29 and lost 24, so he's been far more successful at that level. Played three Indonesians at quarterfinals. He's only won one of them. He lost two to Christie and Ginting, Jonathan Christie. And his overall record against Indonesians is 12 wins and 14 losses.
Quickly returned,
but
no accuracy from Ginting snap from Loh. That was a snatching at that. Nice 4-point lead here for Ginting. Here in the second game, having already taken the first one, and he's in a good position, isn't he, to once again win in straight games. Let's see what happens next. Certainly knows when the player like Ginting's up by that many, he's got to be keeping pace. As far as Loh Kean Yew is concerned, three in a row is his best run in this second game. Finished us off. Could do it then. does now. Keeping himself in the hunt. Only a point in it. Oh, lovely from Loh Kean Yew now. He's done hard work in drawing level. He did this in the last game as well, remember? Plays that late. Recovers well. Oh, he's done it. He's taken the lead. Very nicely done by Loh Kean Yew. Again, the powers of recovery on the ground and then bounces up.
Thank you.
That's a very nice attacking shot right after that. Yeah, couldn't really get any height on that. Difficult from so low down.
Coming over. 14-all.
Gives him the lead here, Loh Kean Yew.
15-14.
Overall has lost to more Indonesians than he's beaten, 12 and 26 his wins. Just went for that, didn't he? He had a 17-15 lead, if I'm not mistaken. Could hold on to it. It's actually 15-13. It's 15-14 there. A couple of unforced errors from him in the previous game. There's one here. Yeah, just so quick to it, wasn't he? Loh Kean Yew's record against top five players in the world. He's won 10 out of 23. That's actually not a bad record, given that he's Lovely, delicate touch from Loh Kean Yew.
Serving over 16 all.
That brings it to 16 all. I was just going to say Loh Kean Yew, but much of his career outside the top 10. It was only really after that World Championships. He was 22 in the world when he won the World Champs. And then soon after that, got into the top 10. It's only been a couple of years since he's been in the top 10. So a number of his victories against top 10 players has been when he's outside the top 10. Five of those 10 victories, half his victories against top 10 players has come outside of being the top 10.
17,
now he's looking at staring at possibly another defeat. He's trailing by one here. Snatching it again, he knows it. Well, you're not seeing the pictures here, but he was really frustrated with himself. Some breathing space here for Ginting. Maybe 50. This picture will show it to you. Reaction here, there you go. Yeah, he feels that one. Ginting in pole position once again. Oh, important, that one. So important to him.
Serving over 17-18.
Absolutely massive there. Any way he can get those points, he will grab right now. Especially against a man he has not beaten in a long time.
Thank you.
So it's been challenging for him to find his way. Close among the top players, and he's now drawn level. We talked about his highs and lows. And he wants to work on his improvement in every aspect. It never ends for him. But maybe that now could be paying dividends. He's 18 all here. He's up, but he can't get down to the other side. He races across, but Ginting puts it away.
Service over. 19.
There again, those legendary powers of recovery from Loh Kean Yew, and even he cannot get across to the other side. That's great placement from Anthony Ginting. Well, Loh Kean Yew said the proof of the work he puts in will be in the competition. The Olympics is the pinnacle of his career. 2024 is going to be significant for him. It represents his best chance of a medal. He spent the early part of this year in Thailand training with the world champion Kudlaput Vittasan, who's actually on the court next to us right now and probably on the verge of getting into the semi-finals. Plan here for this year, according to the Singapore Badminton Association technical director Martin Andrews, that him and Yeo Jamin, who's well number well, the top 20s, is to improve in their rankings and their levels overall. That's wide, 19 all. Low is aiming to be back in the top 8.
Serve it over.
19 all. We'll have a training stint in Denmark as well. Loh Kean Yew closer to the Olympics. And right now, his focus here in this Indonesia Masters semi-final. 19 all. It's going to blink first. Great shot. Oh, it doesn't make it over. I think there was a bit of a net involved. An acknowledgement of that from Ginting. And you can just hear what that means to the crowd as Ginting sets up a slender one-match point. No, it doesn't make it over, does it? There, the net.
20,
prominent at
that
point. 90. You can't believe it again. Loh Kean Yew hits the net. Some fantastic rallies here. And Ginting does the business. Both players are sprawled on the court. They put absolutely everything into this. We have been treated to such a spectacle. Here once are the Indonesian coach up on his feet, getting the crowd going as if they need anything else. What an epic encounter between these two athletes. Both so popular here, and it's Ginting who once again comes out on top against Loh Kean Yew for the sixth straight match. He beats a Singaporean. What about this rally? The kill on the back hand there, just sliding in. He might have just lost his footing as well. And they collapse. An epic, epic encounter. A sixth straight win for Anthony Sinisuka Ginting in straight games against Loh Kean Yew, who can look back and say, well, this is his highest aggregate points against Ginting in those six matches, but it's scant reward. The third seed from Indonesia, Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, beat Singapore's Loh Kean Yew 21-17, 21-19. He's done it in 53 absorbing minutes. We'll be right back.
It's been quite the roller coaster ride, hasn't it, here on court one for the HSBC BWF Indonesia Masters 2024, our final match of the day here on court one. And this quarterfinal day is men's doubles. Paranyu Kao Samang and Warapol Tok Sana of Thailand take on Kim Astrup and Anders Scott of Rasmussen, the second seeds from Denmark. So two spots up for grabs still in the men's doubles